Hey guys, welcome back to Crafty Concepts with Erin. Today I am here with the creative design team and we are featuring the Love Your Stash Challenge for the month of February. This week is week two and it's all about using embellishments. So as you can see here, I have a ton of embellishments on my VersaMat. These are heavy chipboard embellishments from an ocean themed collection. I also have these Recollections seashell stickers that have been in my stash for probably 10 years. So this is the paper pack it's from. This is called Seize the Day. I have a little bit of stickers left over, and this is a retired paper collection, but I'm going to try to use up as much as possible today. So I like to keep a little dish on my desk and I just put my embellishments in there for the time being to keep them organized. And then I'm gonna just work on the base of my layout. I already had this square cut, so I'm going to use that. And this paper, we're going to go with this blue kind of driftwood look. So I probably had gut this out of the center of another paper, and I'm going to do the same with this one. So I just use my paper trimmer and I can save that for another project. And I did mat this one with a piece of sapphire cardstock just to give that nice blue sapphire edge. And then I also found these little maritime puffy stickers in my stash. So I have these two photos of my son, Clayton. We were at the ocean and we were tide pooling. So I thought it'd be fun to put this like he's looking down at that sea anemone. Now these were pre-cut also, so it already has like a hole in it, but I'm gonna cover that up so it doesn't matter. I went ahead and cut these down. All these squares are 4x4. So I'm making a grid layout. And these are really fun because these grids where the pictures aren't make great spots to cluster your embellishments. So I'm using my edge distressor to go around the edges and rough that up and give it some texture and character. And I'm gonna do the same to this one off camera. So now I have my tabs and tags thing cut. I went ahead and cut a sapphire tag and I'm gonna use a nail file and just go around and sand this to show that white core of the cardstock just to give it a nice distressed vibe. Just taking the time to sand the cardstock and distress the edges really adds a lot to your layout. It's those little touches that make a big impact. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start layering up my embellishments. We'll bring that little dish in. And this one says, life is better in flip-flops. And it's perfect because my son is wearing flip-flops and we're at the beach. So that's gonna be my title. And then I just wanna bring in these pieces and I'm just going to layer them and kind of cluster them together to create this little area of embellishments. And then I'll repeat that on the lower right-hand corner as well. So I'm just picking out bits and pieces. This little bird guy's cute, and I like this anchor. And we'll just kind of overlap them slightly. I'm looking through, and I like this seashell here, but I'm not sure if I'll use that. But this sun, sand, and surf, I like having text to kind of balance out the text on the top. And I definitely want to use this sea star. Grid layouts are fun. I haven't done one of these in a while, and they're just kind of classic. You can do, you know, four squares like this, or 3x3 and have 9, all sorts of different configurations. So I like that little yellow starfish there, because there's yellow on the left-hand side of the page. So I'm pretty happy with this. I'm gonna start gluing down my embellishments. I like to use this Tombow Mono Liquid Adhesive for things like this. It goes on really nicely and dries clear. So I'm totally fussing with this sea star because I know I want to include journaling in that upper corner. I want to make sure it's not in the way. So I think that's going to work. And I've already done my journaling on my computer. I printed it out on mink cardstock and cut those into teeny tiny journaling strips. And then I'm just going to layer these, kind of stack these on underneath each other on this open area of my square here. I am a big fan of strip journaling and I just think it looks really cool and I use this a lot. I spot these stickers on the coordinating sticker sheet and they say happy place and sandy toes, and I thought that would be fun to layer over here and just kind of mirror that text. So while I get these down, the journaling just basically talks about how much my youngest son, Clayton, loves the ocean and tide pooling as much as I do, and that just makes me really happy. I grew up visiting the Fitzgerald Marine Reserve in Moss Beach, and now I get to take my kids there and experience the same things that I experienced as a kid, and I just think that's awesome. I love kind of reliving it through their eyes. It brings back so many happy memories. This Fitzgerald Marine Reserve has the best tide pooling too. It's very cool. Highly recommend it. So I am going to bring in some of these stickers from the Recollections. I'm bound and determined to use these. So I think they're very dimensional, very cool. And I thought I'd put just one shell on each cluster. And I think I'm pretty happy with this. These are cool. And I think this is going to look really good and go perfectly. So last but not least, I want to make sure to incorporate some of these puffy maritime stickers. We've got the embellishments, so we are going to use the embellishments. So there is such a thing as going overboard, but I think we're okay so far. So I'm just going to, again, whatever I kind of do in the lower corner, I'm going to carry up into the upper corner just for that continuity. So I'm just using, I'm going to do, I think, just three of those puffy stickers. And now I have string for my giant surplus of string bag there. And we'll just run this through the tag just to give a little texture and finish this tag off. We'll just loop it through. And then I'm going to trim these down a little bit, I think, because they're kind of long. You could let them just hang out the top of your page protector, but I'm going to give them a little haircut. And I'm thinking I want a little bit more yellow on this layout. So I have these adhesive backed yellow sequins, and I'm just going to tuck it underneath. So just kind of peeking out, maybe one here, and I'm gonna do another one right there, but let me grab my tweezers and make it easier. Yep, it like totally sprung out of my tweezers. So perfect, we'll get that tucked there, and I think that looks really good. So we did some serious stash busting on this layout, and I couldn't be happier with the way it turned out. I used retired paper and a ton of these ocean nautical themed embellishments. Tune in tomorrow because Lisa Stenz will have something awesome to share with you guys. If you've missed any of the videos, I will have that linked in the description box below and also right here for you. If you're not already a subscriber, I would love to have you join the Crafty Concepts with Erin community. See you next time.